today we're going to give you a down and dirty on how to replace your rear pads and rotors on your F-150. Now, they're all pretty much the same. The part numbers for the rotor and the pads change throughout the years, but the same procedure pretty much applies from, I would say, you know, 96 on, 97 on, they've been the same. So let's go ahead and start taking them apart and renew the rear brakes on here. All right, so the first thing you want to do is compress the caliper piston back in so we can get some working room here. So we're going to take a C-clamp, or I use a wood clamp, and we're going to compress it right back in. And what this will do is it'll allow us a little free play here to get past rust ridges on the rotor and stuff like that. Now, these actually go in pretty far, so if it can go in pretty far and we're changing the pads out on here, you might as well just compress it in all the way while it's still on here. So, and you can watch it right through here and make sure the piston fully retracts. All right, so at this point, you can get this thing out of here. And then on the back side of the caliper, there's two 10 millimeter bolts right here, okay? And the caliper locks in to the bracket, which is part of the axle assembly here. So let's take those out. Oof. All right. And this is how they look. They're usually, coated with galvanized, so they have zero issues coming out of there. So they should come right out. And at this point, you simply lift up on the caliper. Now, if it is stuck on here for whatever reason, you don't want to fight it. You want to get underneath these pads and help them up. You will break and chunk off the plastic piston in here, I'm telling you. So get it up and off here. Make sure it comes off real free like that. We can simply put our old pad to the side, and you want to keep them because the ears are different on the pad. So you want to keep the right side on the right and the left on the left. Now, for right now, we're just going to take our caliper and we're just going to rest it on this box right here. Okay. So it's held up and we can concentrate on the rotor. I get that off and swapped out. Now, you also want to take these two clips off of here. Your brake pad kit will contain new ones. Plus, you want to get underneath it back here and clean it up. So let's get these off of here all at the same time and get them off to the side. Now, the rotor, you may have a situation where it just does not come off on here. Now, luckily, we're changing the rotors out on here, so you can smack the front of it right here. This one's already loose. Smack the front of it on here, and that'll break the bond to the hub face. Or you can tap in the backside, spin it, tap in the backside, and we can break that bond to the hub face on here. This one, it's already loose. We'll just take it off and get it out of here. Now, once it's off of there, let's get you a better view here. What you want to do is clean the hub face on here if there's any built-up corrosion. And then we're going to apply a light coat of anti-seize on the flange and then around the centering hub here also. So these come off nice and easy next time. And, of course, don't build corrosion. That way you can reuse this over and over again. Now, you may notice on mine there's no parking brakes. The customer actually took them off and threw them away. Doesn't need a parking brake and doesn't want to deal with them. And the problem they came across, which is very common, is they went to go pull the rotor off at some point in time and they noticed the shoes came apart from the backing plate on there, on the shoe backing plate. So you'll probably come across that when pulling the rotor off. You'll notice it binds. And you'll find out why. You'll pull the rotor off and the shoes will just fall off onto the ground. They're just glued onto there and they rust and they break apart and they separate. So be ready for that, the cost of that, if you need the parking brake, okay? It's probably gonna happen. Now this one actually looks pretty darn good. So we'll just do a cleaning of it on the outside here and wipe it down. Make sure all the dirt's off of there. And then we'll apply some anti-seize onto here. Now this reminds me right here, another thing you may wanna watch out for whenever you're pulling these off, because again, it is common. If you see any kind of liquid back in this area right here, you think the brake caliper's leaking or not, make darn sure that it is the caliper, because 90% of the time, it's the axle seals. They're right underneath here, and they do leak down and collect right here, but they also sling it all the way around, all over the caliper and the pads. So it may look like a brake leak, when in all reality, it's axle leak. So check that too while you're in here, since you're this far. Okay, that looks good. So let's go ahead and apply a little bit of anti-seize to the hub here. Now we'll just put it on nice and messy like this at first, and then we'll smear it around with our hands, our finger, and get a nice even coat on there. The one thing you want to avoid is the studs themselves. You want to make sure you don't get any on there, because it's not meant to be on a wheel stud, and it may loosen the nut over time and your wheel may fall off. So you don't want to do that. If you get any on there, just be mindful of it and go after it with some brake clean and a rag and you'll be good to go. So the center here, I'm going a little bit thicker because it is such an area to cover. But we'll also smear it around with our fingers. Okay, you just see, just grab your finger and you go around and around and around and just try to even it on there. All you need is a light coat. We put it on there a little heavy so we could mix it around. This center hub here will do something like this, okay? Now at the very base of the stud, it's okay to get the anti-seize because the nut only goes down this far right here. So this point on, you'll be able to see the difference in the thread color. It's never gonna touch anything. It's never gonna touch the lug nut itself. So just get a good even coat on there and it'll help ease removal next time on there. All right, looks good. Now these two anchor points right here, you wanna go ahead and clean those with a wire brush. Just get the bulk of the scale off of there. And then we'll use a little brake clean and we'll finish them off. Now at the same time, I put a little bit of anti-seize on here. And this will help to prevent corrosion buildup under those anti-rattle clips, because the metal's now coated. So your new clips, they look a little something like this. Okay, you just simply center them over and push them on. If they're fitting extra tight, little tap of the hammer. Now your rotor itself, the brand I recommend is either AC Delco Professional or Motorcraft. They seem to have the best finish on here where the pad rides. So that's just something to think about. And they're also finished here in the center. Either way, you wanna go ahead and clean the surface here. You see there's a lot of oil on here to keep corrosion down. You wanna clean that off with some brake clean before putting it onto there. So I just wash it on down. Make sure you do it on both sides. Paper towel. And we'll get the bulk of it off of there. All right, let's go ahead and put it onto here. There it is, looking better already. All right, let's get the caliper ready to go. We already pushed the piston all the way in, so we can take our old pad out and toss it. Now, like I said, you want to pay attention because you'll notice on one side there's two ears and the other side there's only one. And that's the way it is on the other side, it's just the opposite. So you want to make sure you put it in there correctly for the side you're working on. So keep your old pad on this side and match it, of course, to your new one, okay? So let's put that off to the side. You don't need that anymore. And we're simply gonna go over this one. This one's pretty bad. You can see, guy lives down a dirt road. So we're just gonna get our wire brush in here and we're gonna clean it. Okay, a little bit in the face there. The rest of it. And there shouldn't be too much corrosion in here. We're just gonna get the bulk of it off there if there's excessive amounts. If your boot is not sitting just like this, you wanna get a pick underneath there and pop it, and it'll let the air out of there so it can relax back down to this position. Now you may notice on mine, look at these guides right here. They're just disintegrating, probably original, but there are boot kits out there so you can just change them or the guides also. So we have a new set of boots for it, so we're gonna go ahead and change them out. And that keeps, you know, dirt, water, salt, all that stuff out of here. And the best way I found to get these things out is to actually push them out with a needle nose on here. And they're gonna be kind of a pain. Ugh, there you go. Actually, one big corroded mess. Now this other side on here, it's still going through there and it's coming apart pretty bad. We're just gonna go like this and push it through and get it out of there. So we're down to the bare housing on here. Now mine's not corroded on here. You may wanna go in there with a file, a round file, and clean it out, but mine's not bad. So we'll go ahead and do the same thing on the other side here. And I found a lot of times that pushing this way and out is actually easier. So it's just something to think about. Ugh. Okay. Now after all those pieces are out of there, we're gonna go ahead and clean this up a little bit. So we're gonna use the wire brush once again. I'm just gonna try to get some of this dirt off of here. These old parts out of here. Let's go ahead and spray her on down with some brake clean. You notice we're spraying away from the piston on there. You don't wanna spray underneath the dust boot and get brake clean on there, so. So we'll wipe it over with our hand and a rag at first, okay? And then we'll get some. Compressed air. Now, what you're gonna do is take your old guide here and you're gonna clean it up a little bit and then we'll lube it up and we'll put the new boots and guides in there. Now, what you're gonna do is take your new boots and we're gonna put a little bit of grease right in the center part here. We're gonna try to force it through. Now, you can go either side, it doesn't matter. Again, I found it easiest to just go from the top, kind of get it in there, and push it on through. And it'll pop like that and center and self-center that way. So let's do the same thing for the other side. And this will have nice new boots. Be all sealed up and renewed on here once again. I'm not sure if these holes on here are tapered, but again, like I was saying before, even for the guy, it's easier going from the top. So we'll take our guides that have silicone grease all over them. I'll put a nice amount on there on the outside. I'll go ahead and get these in here. And these ones are gonna be a little bit tougher. Pretty much get it in there and it will self-center. We're gonna go through the other side and we're gonna get locked in, as you can see here. So we're gonna go out. Okay, we're locked in. Now we're gonna come back this way and make sure it does the same exact thing. There is a groove in there. So that's it. Good to go. You can get rid of the grease on the outside. Don't need it. And there it is. Okay, our boots are done. Like new. We can go ahead and grab some more silicone brake grease and we're gonna put it on the ears here. Good healthy dose. And then we're gonna do the same thing for the face of the piston. And this helps prevent any noises. And this stuff won't wash away with water and all that stuff, so it's good stuff to use. Okay, now we're gonna take our pad, our inner pad right here. Again, make sure that the ears match up to the old one. And we're gonna lay it in here. Be very careful not to get no grease in the face of it. And we're gonna put it in here and lock it in just like that. Now this one on the outside here, these clips on here are gonna be extra strong. So we just need to get it onto here, nice and even. And make sure it gets fully seated in there. Now the one thing I make sure of is, you see it looks like it's fully seated. Well, no it's not. You can see there's a gap between the ear and the pad. So you usually need to bring it back up a little bit and you'll find it'll pop into there, into the holes right here. Okay, you just can't see them on this one. So let's make sure it's nice and flat against the ears on here. It may have to come up a little bit like I said and you'll pop right in. You'll be able to tell. There we go. Now you can see it's right against it. Next, we're gonna take our loaded caliper here and we're simply gonna hook it into these brackets right here. You can see on the driver's side here, they're on top. So you wanna hook in the top, okay? And you wanna pull back these guides right here so you can get it around the ear. Okay, so pull it back and it'll fall right into place. So we're gonna go over here. We're gonna start to hook it in. We're gonna pull back that guide, okay? And you'll notice it going in. Same thing on the bottom. Make sure you got the room. And it'll hook right up in there. And then these ones down here do the same thing. You see how they're sitting on there? Up top, they're locked in. Nothing's cocked. And we'll take our bolts and we'll just simply bolt it back in. Now these can be tricky to get into there, right? There's a lot of flexibility in there, so you wanna do it by hand. You know, really get a good feel for it. Make sure you're not cross-threading before you start using a wrench or a socket. And you'll be able to feel it. I can feel right away. So at that point, we'll just simply tighten these up. And if you just, you know, you can go by feel easily on these if you use a little 10 mil wrench like this. It's gonna be really freaking hard to over torque these if you're using a little wrench like this and you have barely any leverage. So I'll just go ahead and snug them up on here. All right, there you go. It's all installed like new once again. Give it a good visual. Make sure everything looks right. The pads are facing the rotor. Your boots look right. Your bolts look right. Make sure your hose is not twisted in any way. It is possible. You want it to be a nice loop like this. Okay. Good visual. And that's it. Put your tire back on. Torque to spec. The lug nut torque is 150 foot-pounds for almost all the model years. Now, once the brake job is completed on both the driver's side and the passenger side, wheels are back on, torque to spec. You want to come back into the vehicle, leave it in park as you can see here. We're going to start the vehicle up. We're going to get some vacuum going to the booster. And then we're going to come down to our brake pedal here. And we're going to press on it a couple times until we get that nice firm pedal from the brake pedal here. What's happening at first is you'll notice the pedal just go all the way to the floor. Don't freak out. What's happening is the caliper piston is taking up the slack in there between the caliper piston and the pads themselves, okay? So it's very important they come in here and hit the brake pedal a couple times so we can get a nice firm pedal before ever pulling it out of park. Besides that, go for a drive, listen for any kind of weird noises, and then you come back and retorque your lug nuts, very important, and the job is complete. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, helping you fix your Ford yourself.